Hi, I'm Professor M.L. Robinson with the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension in Southern Nevada. And I'm going to talk to you about a subject that many gardeners take advantage of but don't really think about, and that is microclimates. All a microclimate is a smaller area of the garden that has a little bit different climatic conditions. They're cooler in the summer, shadier, but for some reason it has qualities that benefit plant materials that wouldn't be out in the full sun or in the rest of the landscape. Today I'm standing in our beautiful courtyard, and as part of the design of this building, we had a large courtyard design. Now, courtyards have been used for thousands of years in desert and Mediterranean climates to moderate the climate for both people, animals, and as well as plants, and plants play an important role in that. As you look at this courtyard, we've done several things to modify it. Rather than having lots of hardscape and rocks and few plants, we have a little bit of hardscape, the sidewalks and a few benches. We have lots of mulch beds with plants that shade and add humidity to the landscape. We mulch with organic mulch that improves the soil but also adds to the humidity here. And then overhead, we have these beautiful sunscreens that add even more cooling. As you look behind me and around me, we have tropical and subtropical plants that really don't do well in our desert climate. But because of the microclimate that I'm standing in this courtyard, they do. Behind me is a wall of glass and classrooms and offices that protect these plants from the north and northwest winter winds. And so I have a Bismarckia palm, which is from Madagascar, that is subtropical to tropical, thriving in this little situation that would have died long ago if it had been planted on the outside in the landscape. Behind me I have the beautiful lady palm, or Rapis excelsis. Again, a subtropical palm that does well along rivers in humid conditions, but these are thriving in this special little microclimate that has been created. But we have a tropical rubber tree, the lady palms, and all of this is possible because of the microclimate. How can you find where your microclimates are? Well, there's several ways. Number one, observe in the community, your neighbors, and other homes around as you drive around. Is that special plant that you would like to grow but it seems impossible to grow where you live? Look and see if anyone else is being successful in growing it. Another way is to observe commercial buildings and landscape. Here in Southern Nevada and Las Vegas, we have lots of wonderful resorts that are theming their landscapes, and they grow a lot of plant material that we wouldn't normally see in our landscapes here. When I go to work with their clientele, and you as a visitor can also. So pick out that plant that said, gee, I'd like to grow that in my yard. How can they grow it here? And of course, you can experiment yourself. Many chain stores order in plants that really aren't appropriate for where you live. But if you find that microclimate, they might do well. So experiment. And number four, and perhaps the most important way, call your cooperative extension office. Professors such as myself and our master gardener will be more than happy to help you and teach you about microclimates and what plants will and will not grow in those. So remember, as we find those microclimates, we push the envelope, grow some of those specialty plants that we want to, but at the same time, utilizing shade and organic mulch and north or south sides of buildings. Well, we're going to conclude this video standing in my own personal little tropical paradise here in this microclimate of our courtyard. I'm Professor M.L. Robinson with the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada.